Now, all the things we've been hearing about this morning, the way we shine like stars, the way we stand out as being different, the way we hold out the word of life, the way we train the next generation, the way we care, bottom line is, it's exciting in a sense because those things are coming together in a way that's more effective than in the past, sustainable as our team consolidates. Those things are being what a church should be. Those things are our vision. But there is one more goal we've got for 2016, and that is the conviction that it's time to get serious about our facilities for the future. Now, let me just say, that is a minor goal compared to the challenge of shining like stars. But in a lot of ways, it's very helpful if we can get it right. And so you'll be able to see, if you're looking through the booklet, there are some exciting plans and images on pages 13 to 17 in the booklet. We've been working on this stuff for a while, to the point where you might have been wondering, if you're a long-term MPC person, if anything was ever going to happen. There were plans for a building down on the corner near the railway, but when the costings came through at around $5 or $6 million, we just didn't think it was doable. It had to be on stilts because of the grade of the land. We'd need to duplicate all the amenities over there. And our in-house architect, Matt Smith, and the building committee went back to the drawing board and came up with this instead, where you can see the auditorium located where the green box is. I want you just to take a look at this brief video to set the scene.
After the service, take a few minutes to look over the proposed location of the new building marked out with orange cones. It takes up a big slice of the car park and faces into our current courtyard, which will be 5 metres wider. The new building is designed to seat up to 500 people, giving plenty of space to grow followers of Jesus for the next generation. It's designed around modular dimensions for easy and inexpensive construction. We'll be sharing facilities with the current hall, with kitchen and bathroom facilities getting a much needed upgrade. A beautiful glass atrium area will link the two buildings, a great space to meet and mingle outside the main entry to the new auditorium. We've been listening to your feedback and doing our best to trim costs as we've reworked our plans over the last few years. So take a look around, look over the plans, and see if you can imagine a fresh new look for MPC.
Now, I need to say what you'll be looking at today is a very initial concept, but the location and the scale particularly are the kind of key issues we're looking at. So far as our elders have seen it and our management committee members have seen it, there has been real enthusiasm, and we think it's time to get moving. So we want you to have a wander around the car park after the service, look for the orange cones, watch out for cars as you do that, but try to visualise it. It does take up a fair amount of the car park that we've got at the moment, but of course the houses over there will have to be taken away, and that will then enlarge our car park to nearly twice what it is at the moment. We would love to get your comments on comment slips on the table out there by the plan board after the service. After all this effort in the first service, I think we got one comment in, and that was someone who said, "Let's do it," so at least that's positive. But we would just love to get feedback from you. Next week there's going to be an informal forum after each of the services, and the plan is we can spend some time there. If we need to go into the afternoon, we can. But we really need to hear from you. If you hate the idea, or especially I reckon if you love the idea, if you have questions about it, next week is the time we'll be working through all that. If we're going to go ahead, you'll need to solidly agree. We together as a group will need to solidly agree. And we will, of course, need to start a fund. And if you can afford it, we will need you to consider giving generously on top of all our other ministry priorities as well. We're looking for, at best guess, $2.5 million, maybe $3 million over the next few years, which is half the cost of the original designs. And ultimately, it is our gift to the next generation. Now, we can work in some pretty easy stages. They're described in the vision booklet. But as the Board of Elders talked through it, you know, over the last few days, we were saying, why not just go for it and get it done? That, of course, ultimately depends on what you think about it, which we'll be finding out, I hope, over the next couple of weeks. You can chat to Kathy Linden or chat to Matt Williams from the Site Development Committee or an elder or Kim or to me. Just let us know your thoughts. But again, here is the point. A building is not our vision. The church at Philippi was only small. It met at Lydia's house. We are bigger. We need a bigger house. But the house isn't the church. And the house is not the vision. Our vision is to be people who shine like stars in the universe because we're different. Our vision is to hold forth the word of life, making the gospel clear however we can to all different kinds of people. Our vision is to train new generations of gospel workers for the future. Our vision is to be a church that cares, where we care for one another in a way that lives out and demonstrates the gospel. And we want to do all that without grumbling or arguing, and with real joy, shining like stars, radically different because of the way God is working in us to will and to act according to his good purpose. Please do read through the booklet carefully at home. Before your nap this afternoon, just have a read through it. It won't take long. Grab the financial pages from up the back if you're a financial person and you want them in detail. Please be here next week for our open discussions after each service. And please plan to be here for our congregational meeting in 2 weeks' time, when we'll be locking in our intentions on the budget for the year ahead, on our staffing plans, and starting to get some clarity on those second level questions about going ahead with building. Paul said, do everything without grumbling, and that is very hard, I know. Grumbling, I think, is complaining in the background when the right thing to do is ask openly and listen to one another graciously. And there will be plenty of opportunities to do that. Now, it's been great to think through this stuff this morning. I hope you're excited by what God's doing among us. It's been great to be served by the Late Church Band. They're going to lead us in a song to close our service in a moment. The song, There Is No Other Name.
Redeemed, through whom your grace abounds, no one.